Friends, here we are discussing about basic concepts of REST APIs. See, the basic concepts of REST APIs are like base URL, endpoints, resource, and HTTP verbs or methods or operations. See, these are the very basics you have to know before implementing any REST APIs. Fine. First, let me go with base URL and endpoints. Now here, to explain about base URL and endpoints, I am considering a dummy REST APIs from this website. Just open your browser and search for dummy REST APIs list. And just open the first URL. And here, just scroll down. And see that there are some list of available REST APIs. Just list out them. I already listed them here. See, these are the available REST APIs for some application, dummy application. Fine. Now, if you observe here, in each and every REST API up to this .com, that point is called simply base URL or root endpoint. So, if you want to implement any REST APIs, first you have to decide what is your base URL. That's it. And apart from this base URL, whatever the remaining part is there in each and every REST API, those are called simply endpoints or routes. So now, from your above REST APIs, the available endpoints are /API/V1/employees. So up to this, this is a base URL. The remaining part is endpoint. So likewise, here we have these endpoints. Right? So finally, complete REST API is nothing but your base URL plus endpoint. So if you have n number of endpoints, you are going to get n number of REST APIs. Now here, there is a purpose with endpoint. What is that? We will discuss very soon. Now see that. Our next concepts are resource and HTTP verbs. See, resource is simply a data in web application. Just assume that you are running a website to maintain your employees' information. So here, each employee information is a data or is a resource. And we are using endpoints to work with your resources or data. So in your REST API, base URL plus endpoints. Now that endpoints are helpful to work with your data or resource. That's it. Now, see, sometimes you want to get the existing resource or existing employee information or existing data. So in that case, you have to perform different operation on your endpoint. Sometimes I need to create a new employee information in my web application. So in that case, you have to perform other operation on your endpoints. So we have to execute different operations or methods on endpoints based on our requirement. So that operation or methods are called simply HTTP verbs. So there are some HTTP verbs. They are like get, post, put, patch, and delete. See, these methods simply are called HTTP verbs. And there is a special meaning for each and every HTTP verb or method or operation. Suppose I want to get the existing information, existing employee information from my running web application, then you have to execute get method on your REST API with respect to your endpoint. I want to create a new employee information. I want to create a new resource in my web application. Then you have to execute post method on your REST API with respect to your endpoint. Same way, if you want to update the existing information or update the existing resource, then you have to execute put method on your REST API with respect to your endpoint. And if you want to update partially, then you have to select patch method. And if you want to delete, you have to use delete method. That's it. Okay. Now let me take one of the simple method or HTTP verb to get the existing information. Suppose we have here list of available REST APIs, right? So this is base URL plus endpoint. And on this endpoint, available method is get. Right? Now, let me execute that. Curl. So, I want to execute get method on this REST API. So, simply use -x get That means you are executing get method on this REST API. Just enter. See that you are getting some data, no? And most of the cases, the response, see this data is nothing but a response. Most of the cases, this response is in the form of JSON. And sometimes you're also getting that response as XML or some CSV. And very rarely you're going to get response as text. That's it. So guys, by this, you are good with what is base URL, what are the endpoints, what is a resource, and what are the available methods in your REST APIs. So be clear, before implementing any REST API, you have to decide what is your base URL. After that, you have to select your required endpoints. After that, you have to select your required methods on each and every endpoint. So how to select, how to create this, all those things we'll see while implementing our REST APIs. Okay, guys, thank you for watching this video.